Hey, how you doing? I'm Elton, and this is the final part of the Docker MTA series, Modernizing .NET Apps for IT Pros. In part 4, I deployed my .NET 3.5 application to a staging environment built with Docker for Azure. Docker Cloud works with AWS and Azure, and it provisions a swarm using Docker Community Edition, which is fine for non-production environments. For production, you'll want support for your containers, an integrated management solution, and secure software controls. You get that with Docker Enterprise Edition, which you can run in the cloud or in your own data center. In this video, I'll cover Docker EE Advanced. I'll deploy and manage my application using Universal Control Plane, and I'll show you how security, administration, and monitoring work in a production Docker environment. Docker Enterprise Edition gives you fine control over how you set things up. You can provision a cluster in the cloud with a template from Docker, or you can prepare your own cluster manually in the data center. It's very simple to deploy Docker EE, and the Advanced Edition comes with a comprehensive management suite, Docker Trusted Registry, which I've already used as the private registry for my images, and Universal Control Plane, which is the container management platform. This is Universal Control Plane, UCP. It's a single pane of glass for monitoring your entire environment. The dashboard is an overview of the containers which are running and any which have errors or unknown state. It also shows basic infrastructure metrics, the aggregate CPU and memory usage for the manager nodes and the worker nodes. From here, there are shortcuts showing you how to do the key tasks, like adding a node to the cluster. That's as simple as installing Docker on a machine in the UCP network and running this command. From the dashboard, you can also download a client bundle, which you use with your local Docker command line to securely connect to UCP. UCP has a rich access control model, which applies across the UI and the Docker command line. Access control gives you huge flexibility over how you use UCP in production. I've signed in to UCP, which also means I'm signed in to DTR. There's single sign-on between the two. I'm using a UCP managed account, and you can also configure authentication with an LDAP provider, so you can link UCP to Active Directory and use Windows accounts to log in. Authorization is separate from authentication, and that's controlled completely within UCP. You create organizations and teams to group users, and these are the subjects for access control. Users can be in multiple teams, and their permissions are the superset of all the team's permissions. The targets for access control are collections, which are groups of Docker resources. You can put any resource into a collection, like nodes, volumes, containers, or images. The final piece of access control is the grant, which is how you assign permissions so that subjects can use the resources in a target collection. The flexible role-based access control in UCP lets you segregate your cluster in whatever way works for your organization. As a simple example, this worker node is in the Unit 1 collection, which could represent a business unit. Only members of the admin team have scheduler access to the Unit 1 collection, which means you have to be a user in the admin team to run containers on that worker node. Access control lets you segregate a large cluster to give dedicated compute resources to different areas of the business, as well as defining fine-grained permissions within teams. You can also use security in UCP to enforce policies over the software that the cluster will run, using Docker Content Trust. Content Trust is a mechanism for digitally signing Docker images to establish provenance, and you enable it on the client with an environment setting. When you push an image to DTR with Content Trust enabled, you sign it with the certificate that you get from UCP in your client bundle, so Docker can securely link a signature to a user. Here, I can see that version 5 of my app image is signed, but the other versions are not. DTR records that an image has been signed, and it also records all the users who are signatories for that image, which you can use as proof of sign-off for a software release. In the admin settings of UCP, under Docker Content Trust, you can require that the cluster will only run images that are signed by known UCP users. You can even specify a list of teams that need to be signatories. So this configuration means images need to have been signed by users in the admin team. I can try to deploy a stack using my V4 application image, which isn't signed, and UCP refuses to run it. There's no way around that. Even administrators can't run unsigned images. This is a security policy which is easy to audit, and it's enforced by the platform. To deploy my app now, I need to use signed images, so I'll need to use new versions in my compose file. This compose file uses versions of my application image and Prometheus image which I've signed in DTR. There's no database image here because in production I'm using a SQL Azure database. You can integrate Docker containers with other services in your network, so running UCP on Azure, I can connect my Dockerized web app to a cloud database. If I was running in the data center, I could connect the web app in a container to a local SQL Server database. I'm making use of one more Docker security feature here, secrets, which are a first-class resource in Docker Swarm mode and in UCP. I'm using a secret to store my database connection string. In the compose file, I reference the secret by name, and the actual content of the secret is securely stored in the Swarm. I'll create that secret in UCP and paste in the connection string. Once I save this, the data is no longer visible. Not even administrators can see the plain text of the secret. The contents only get delivered unencrypted to the services which need it, and V5 of my web app is configured to read the connection strings from the secret file in the container. In UCP, I'll create a stack and upload my compose file. These images are all signed, so UCP will run them and deploy my app. I've set up my UCP infrastructure in a similar way to Docker for Azure, with a load balancer in front of the worker nodes and a public IP address for the load balancer. When I browse to the address, I see the same old app, but now it's running in a container in UCP, connecting to a SQL Azure database, with a connection string securely stored in a Docker secret. I've used SQL Server in a container for non-production environments, and now in production, I've switched to a managed SQL service just by changing the configuration. The last thing I want to show you is how monitoring looks in UCP. UCP is a centralized portal, and I'm logged in with administrator rights so I can see all the resources in the system. In the stacks, there's my own newsletter application, and there's also UCP and DTR. The Docker Enterprise Edition products all run as containers too. Stacks are a group of resources, and I can inspect the services to see the current status. From the service, I can inspect the containers, and I see the combined CPU and memory usage of all the containers in the service. Inspecting the container shows its configuration, like the startup command and any volume mounts, and the environment variables. From here, I can also see the container logs, and I can even run a console session and run commands inside the container. All of this is available from the UI, and it's all subject to access control. So I could set up permissions for testers to be able to view containers and see the logs, but not be able to stop or start containers. The management of services and containers is the same, no matter what technology the container is using. The DTR registry container is a Go application running on Linux, but I can see the configuration and read the logs and connect to the container in the same way as I did with the newsletter website, which is an ASP.NET app running on a Windows Server container. You secure, deploy, and manage all your services in the same way with Docker. UCP provides you infrastructure monitoring of containers and nodes, and you can bring your own application monitoring. My application stack includes the Prometheus monitoring from the last video, and I can browse to the endpoint and see the same performance metrics in production that I have in the test environments. These values are from the performance counters in the ASP.NET container, and it's the same monitoring experience that a developer has when they run locally. And that's the end of the series. In this video, I've shown you how Docker Enterprise Edition gives you a production-grade containers as a service solution in your own data center or in the cloud. You can run a Docker EE cluster with high availability for UCP, DTR, and your own applications with just 6 servers, and you can scale that up to hundreds of nodes. You can mix Linux and Windows servers, and you can manage them all in exactly the same way. On your servers, you just install the operating system and Docker. Everything else you deploy and manage using containers. UCP is the single pane of glass that gives you a consistent way of managing diverse workloads. That includes new apps and old apps. The focus of this series has been on modernizing traditional .NET applications without changing code. You can add portability, security, and efficiency to existing apps without any development effort, and running in Docker is the easiest way to move those apps to the cloud or onto modern infrastructure. If you're keen to try this out for yourself, on the Play with Docker website, there are self-paced labs where you can practice modernizing .NET applications in a sandboxed environment before you move on to your own apps. My name's Elton. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned to the Docker YouTube channel for more great videos on using Docker. And head to docker.com/MTA for more information on starting your own journey modernizing traditional apps with Docker.